late in our own safe space.
Lying awake in my bed, I hear the sound of a thousand feet.
And I'm always modeling because calming there's a kid who can't come up with something to do that he or she can just do what I'm doing.
All up and down my street. Been around bugs with polka dots on them, dancing as they eat. Listen to the sound of my favorite insect, drumming out a sound that's so sweet. But it's a ladybug bee.
Oh, finally, here we go. Oh, no. All right, here we go. Chomp, 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 chomp. Eat up those aphids. All right, do we have full bellies now? We ready to go? All right, let's do some more dancing around. We have a belly full of aphids.
Yes, it's a ladybug bee. Oh, when the sun goes down, those ladybugs come around, tapping on the tiny feet to the sound of a ladybug beat.
Oh, no, find your leaf. Find your leaf. Here we go. And chop up those aphids. So we're just kind of listening for. Music is on, music is off, responding, and actually, you know, maybe even exploring form a little bit, music on, music off, and just kind of in a fun, imaginative way to eat up those aphids. All right, and I might do this freeze game with a variety of different things, if it's ladybugs on leaves, or I might put like different, you know, find a flower and you have to come back to your flower, or I've done things like, I make kite finger puppets, and I put kite, like ribbons for kite strings taped to the walls, so your kite has to match up with a string when the music stops. So, thank you, ladybugs. That piece of music was called Ladybug Beat by the Sippy Cups, and it's on iTunes. But when I'm doing movement with little guys, I mean, I don't necessarily always use music that's